Welcome to Turner Classic Movies, everybody. Thanks for joining us for this week's edition of Silent Sunday Night. I'm Ben Mankiewicz. While this week's feature is not a movie related directly to the holiday season, it's certainly a story about faith. From 1928, Danish director Carl Theodor Dreyer's masterpiece, The Passion of Joan of Arc. Released just 8 years after Joan of Arc was canonized as Saint Joan by the Catholic Church, the film focuses on her trial in an English court in the 15th century. She was a peasant girl accused of being a heretic and claiming she saw visions of God and hearing his voice while leading the French army to victories in the Hundred Years' War. Dreyer assembled an impressive team to tell the story, including Herman Varm, who created the striking sets for the cabinet of Dr. Caligari from 1920, and also a future director, Rudolf Maté, to do the camera work. Perhaps most importantly, Dreyer cast Renée Maria Falconetti in the title role. A former Boulevard Theater comedian in France, she delivers what many consider the greatest performance in silent screen history. Some argue it's the best performance in the history of motion pictures. As you'll see, the entire film is dependent on the expressiveness of Falconetti's face. Reportedly, Dreyer treated Falconetti harshly and put her through intense physical hardship in an effort to get her expressions to reflect Joan's suffering. Despite her performance, which cemented her place in cinema history, this was Falconetti's only film role. She died, largely forgotten, in Argentina 18 years later in 1946. But here, on screen, her legacy endures. From 1928, The Passion of Joan of Arc. The official credits say that The Passion of Joan of Arc is based on a novel, but as it turned out, director Carl Theodor Dreyer primarily used transcripts from Joan of Arc's trial. He was equally as obsessive about historical details, set design, costuming, and even makeup, or in this case, lack of makeup. No one in the film was allowed to wear any makeup. It was part of Dreyer's effort to keep the production as historically accurate as possible, and also because Dreyer believed the absence of makeup gave more power to the pure expression on his actors' faces. Up next, this week's TCM import, a French epic filmed amid the chaos and danger of World War II.